Hi guys, how are you? Okay, so now tell me, how do I look like? Like, I have long hair, okay, I have a fair complexion, okay, any other thing, any other word that you can use to describe me or any of your friend or any of your cousin, maybe brother or maybe your sister, because I think that many a times we are short of words when we want to describe someone, just like it happened with me last year as well. So a friend of mine called me up and she was like, you know what, I'm getting married by the end of the year. So I congratulated her a lot because obviously she's getting married, she's going to start a new life. I congratulated her. Then I told her, okay, so tell me about your fiance. How does he look like? Can you send me a picture of his? So she was like, right now I don't have his picture. So I was like, okay, fine, you can just tell me about him. Just describe me how he looks. So what I find was she was short of words. She wasn't actually having words with which, you know, she can use to describe her fiance. So that thing has made me make this lesson for you guys, because in this lesson we are going to talk about those words which we use for describing about the physical appearance of person or physical appearance of people. So without wasting time, let's get started. My name is Sanya and I welcome you all in today's lesson. Okay guys, so we'll firstly start with height. Okay, so height, you know, obviously, definitely you all must be knowing. So a person may be tall, like I can say Amitabh Bachchan is very tall because he is tall. I can add very because I'm saying he's very tall. Okay, then I can say short, someone who is short, who is not so tall. But what if a person is neither tall nor short? So I can say that, you know, he or she is of medium height or average height. So I can say medium height or average height. He or she is of medium or average height. Okay, now guys, if you want to be more precise, okay, if you want to give more specific information regarding height, so like maybe you can say, I don't know exactly, but I think that he is around 5 foot and 6 inches. So like, you know, I'm just telling, I'm not giving actual information, like around 5 foot or 6 inches. So around 5 foot 6 inches. Okay, so you can also say he's very tall or short, he's of medium height or he's of average height, or maybe you can also say he's around 5 foot 6 inches, I guess. Okay, so this is how we describe height of a person. Now let's move on. Now next up we have hair. Okay, so our hair, all right. Okay, so how can we describe? So how do you pronounce this? Bald. No guys, that's the wrong pronunciation. It is pronounced as bald. There's no a sound in this. Okay, so we pronounce it as bald. So it actually means a person with no hair or very less hair on head. Okay, okay. Now the next up which we have is, okay, there's a spelling mistake, no problem, this is blonde. Okay guys, now I think that many of you must not be knowing the meaning of blonde. Now this is also not pronounced as blondie, this is not blondie guys, this is pronounced as blonde. Blonde we use for a person who has yellow hair, just like Britishers, they mostly have yellow hair. Okay, so a person with yellow hair or golden hair as well. Okay, so now if next time you see a person who is having yellow hair, you will not say he was having yellow hair. You will say he was having blonde hair, because I have taught you here that blonde hair. Okay, now not blondie, it's blonde. Okay, okay. Now next up we have is redhead. Now redhead doesn't mean having red hair. Actually, redhead means a person who has orange hair. Just like many a times it happens, we get our hair color changed. Okay, so a person who has orange hair and not red hair. Okay, so next is cropped hair. Now cropped hair means very short hair, guys, extremely short hair. Okay, not till here, like only till here, just like this. Just like usually boys have short hair, so girls can also have cropped hair as well, right? So very short hair. Now one more thing that I would like to tell you guys over here is that related to hair, we talked about yellow hair, we talked about red hair. What if what we call if a person is having white hair? You will say, ma'am, we will say white hair only. But no, they are known as gray hair. We don't say white hair, we say gray hair. So gray hair means, just like mostly when people get old, so they usually have gray hair, they start developing gray hair. Okay, so gray hair doesn't means gray, it actually means to have white hair. Okay, so don't get confused with the word. To have white hair. Okay, now similarly, I can say that if a particular person, like she has long hair, okay, cropped hair, you know, so I can say long hair, or I can also say shoulder length hair. So shoulder length hair will be like around till my shoulder, or till here. Okay, so that is shoulder length hair. Okay, so if I talk about myself and if I ask about myself, so what do you think? Do I have shoulder length hair or do I have long hair? Yes, definitely I have long hair. I don't have shoulder length hair. And are they blonde? They are not blonde. Are they redhead? No. Are they gray? Definitely not. I'm too young to have gray hair, guys. I have black hair. Okay? Fine. Now, similarly, we can also say that a particular person has straight hair. Okay? Or I can say curly hair. Curly hair are like this. You know, when you have lots of SS pattern, you will observe lots of S pattern in curly hair. Okay? Or I can say wavy hair. Now, wavy hair is something like it will be straight, and then when you'll reach the end of the hair, then it will be a little wavy. So that are wavy hair. Okay? So I hope this is clear to you, and you can explain a person with hair now. So we'll move on. And now we'll talk about body type, the structure of a person. Okay? Okay. So now be very careful when using these words, guys, because most of them might hurt the sentiments of other people as well. Okay? So first word is fat. Fat means, you know, a person who is overweight. Okay? But if you say this straight away to someone, oh my God, you're looking so fat. Trust me, you will hurt the sentiment of that particular person. So never say like this that, oh my God, you're looking fat. Because talking about body build and weight is really not a good thing. Especially body shaming. Body shaming means when we are insulting a person because of their body shape. Okay, so we should never do that. Fat means a person who is overweight. Obese also means a person who is overweight, but these two are very impolite. Okay, remember guys, they sound too rude. Very rude. If you want to tell a person that, you know, you are fat, you are unable to control your emotions, okay, and you have to tell that person that, no, I am going to tell him or her today that he or she is really fat. So guys, maybe you can say plump, okay. Plump also means that you are a bit overweight, but it doesn't sound impolite and harsh. And mostly we use this word in British English. Britishers mostly use this word plump instead of using obese, fat. Okay, so plump also means overweight, but this is a polite way of addressing someone that you are overweight. Similarly, I have the word chubby here. Now, I think that all of you must have heard of that nursery rhyme, chubby cheeks, dimpled chin, rosy lips, cheeks within. Okay, so over there, chubby cheeks means rounded cheeks. Okay, so chubby means a person who is round and plump. Round and plump means from the head to toe, that person is like this. Okay, there are no curves in the body of that person. Okay, all the diameters are the same and that person is quite overweight. So this is also a very sweet way of addressing someone. Like if you say to someone, oh wow, you're so chubby. So now you know that person will take it as a compliment because this is such a sweet word. So you can use it. Okay, now the next we have is stout. Now stout is used for a person who is short and who is fat. Okay, so a person who is short and who is fat. So you can use stout, short and fat. Okay, so these are the words which we use for a heavier person. Okay, now over here we have these two which we use for a person who is light in weight, who is lighter. So the first word which we have is skinny. Skinny means a person who is very thin. Now again guys, this is very impolite, right? You can't say this directly to anyone that, God, you're too skinny, okay? That person will get offended. So this is impolite. Okay, instead of using this word, you can use the word slim or you can use the word slender. Okay, because slim is something that people find, oh wow, I'm slim, I'm fit and healthy. Okay, and you can also use the word slender because they are not impolite. Okay, they are like, they sound sweet when you tell a person that you look slim or you look slender. Okay, now the next word which we have is muscular. So muscular means a person who is having a very firm, stiff and toned body and a person who does lot of exercise. So maybe I can say that if we go to gym regularly, okay, or if we gym regularly, we might have a muscular body. Or maybe I can give you an example of there are so many Bollywood stars who have a muscular body. Just like if I talk about John Ibrahim. Okay, so he has got muscles and he has a very toned body. Alright, so that is the meaning of muscular. Next we have is flabby. Flabby means a person who does not do much exercise. And because of that, that person has loose skin. Okay, the skin is not firm. It becomes loose. Alright, so that is flabby. Okay, now these are some of the other words which we can use to describe a person. Okay, so first is gorgeous or attractive. Both the words means a person who is beautiful, a person who is good looking actually. Okay, so good looking. Like I can say that I find Priyanka Chopra very gorgeous. Okay, so one more thing to notice here guys is that we can use both these words for males and females. Okay, but if I talk about the word beautiful, beautiful also means that, you know, you look really nice, but you can't use this word for a man. Okay, you can't use the word beautiful for a male. I can't say that Hrithik Roshan is very beautiful. No, it will be wrong. I can't use that word. I can say Hrithik Roshan is gorgeous. Hrithik Roshan is attractive. But I will not say that Hrithik Roshan is beautiful. Okay, so be very careful We use beautiful only for females and not for males. Okay? And of course, handsome as well. We can use the word handsome. For? Handsome for male and not for females. Remember. Okay. Next up we have scruffy. I hope you might not be knowing the meaning of scruffy. Now, scruffy actually means a person whose appearance is very untidy. Okay? Just like if I talk about beggars, so they have a very untidy appearance. You know, they are not nicely dressed or well dressed. Okay? So that is scruffy. A person whose appearance is untidy. Okay, now the next word is unkempt. Now guys, unkempt is related to scurvy only. Okay, unkempt means a person who is scurvy and that person doesn't even care about his or her appearance. Okay, so just like you know that beggars have a scurvy appearance, and what do you think that if beggars start thinking about how do we look, do you think they might get something from people? No, never. They won't get anything from the people if they well dress themselves and go to the traffic signals and then start begging. No, they'll definitely not get anything. Okay? So unkempt means a person who is scruffy and they don't even care about their appearance. Okay? So a person who is scruffy and doesn't care about appearance. Okay. So guys, I think you must have understood the meanings of all the words, and now you are having so many words with you to describe the physical appearance of maybe your friend or maybe any of your family relative or your cousin or your brother or your sister. So please start using these words, because when you'll start using these words, you will get very fluent in English. So if you found this video helpful, do like this video, subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye and take care.